Hello students, today we are going to learn chapter 5 of Value Education, that is Pasture, the Compassionate Scientist of Standard 7. The meaning of compassion is helping to those who are hurt. So before we start this lesson, see on the first page of this chapter, one picture is given. In this picture, you will see some people are there and they need help. So you have to color to those who need help. So now let us start the story. Mary had just returned from her school. She was thirsty. "Mary, you can have a cup of milk," called her mother. Mary went into the dining hall. "Mummy, the milk is spoiled," she cried out. Means Mary cried out. Her mother came in. "Let me see. Yes, this milk is spoiled," her mother said. So she took out a sachet from the cupboard. "See, Mary, the milk in the sachet is airtight," Mary's mother said to Mary. But Mary could not understand. The milk got from the milk vendor in the morning got spoiled. But the sachet got from the supermarket few days back was still good. "How is that?" she asked her mother the reason for this. Her mother explained, "The sachet milk is pasteurized. The milk taken from the milk vendor is not the pasteurized one." "But what is the meaning of pasteurized?" asked Mary to her mother. "Pasteurizing is a scientific method. Fresh milk is boiled to a high degree, then it is cooled rapidly. In this process, the germs in the milk get killed. This was first done by Louis Pasteur. His name is given to this process because first time it was done by the Louis Pasteur, so that is why his name is given in this process. Who is Louis Pasteur? Louis Pasteur was a chemist. He was born in 1822 in a town in France. His parents were not rich, but they gave him a good education. He secured a degree in science. His marks in chemistry were not high, but his interest in chemistry made him continue his studies in chemistry. He spent a lot of his time in the laboratory. He was continually looking through a microscope at the germs. Means Louis Pasteur was doing. He was continually looking through a microscope at the germs. His professor, means Louis Pasteur's professor, made a fun of him. "They are useless to man. You are wasting your time," he said. Means Pasteur's professor said to Pasteur. But Pasteur replied, "Sir, the germs cause sickness. I must find out which germs cause which diseases." "Where do germs come from?" asked his professor to Louis Pasteur. "Sir, that I must find out," replied Pasteur. And Pasteur found out after a long and patient work. The germs are present in water, in earth, dust, and even in the air that we breathe. These germs turn milk sour. Milk is a carrier of germs. These germs can cause diseases like tuberculosis and typhoid. He made many experiments. Means Pasteur made many experiments. Finally, Pasteur found out the method to kill the germs in the milk. Pasteur did not stop with milk. He continued his research. anthrax, diphtheria, and rabies were terrible diseases. Pasteur found out certain vaccines. These vaccines can prevent and cure these terrible diseases. So that was all done by the Louis Pasteur. One day, a mother brought her son, Joseph, to Pasteur. Joseph had been bitten by a mad dog. He had 14 wounds all over his body. The dog had rabies. Rabies is a kind of disease. Everyone felt sorry for the boy. They said, "The child is sure to die." Even Pasteur had no hopes. But Pasteur had decided to save the boy. So what Pasteur did? Pasteur had prepared a serum from a rabbit. The rabbit had died of rabies. He injected the serum into the boy's body. At first, in small quantities, slowly he increased the dosage. On the 9th day, Joseph showed improvement. He was out of danger now. In 3 months' time, Joseph walked out of the hospital. He had been cured. The year was 1885. Many had been bitten by the mad dogs, but no one had escaped death. Since 1885, thousands of lives have been saved by anti-rabies treatment. The world has to thank Louis Pasteur. Louis Pasteur is considered to be the greatest scientist of France. So children's moral of this story is, compassion begins with sympathy, which is seeing someone's pain. It is noticing a student who skins his knee or a friend who hurts her arm. It is being alert to a weary co-worker or a stranger who needs assistance. Compassion also includes empathy. Compassion also includes empathy, which is feeling someone's pain. Once you notice an injury, empathy means you imagine how much it hurts. This creates a feeling of duty, responsibility, and sometimes urgency to help find a remedy. This brings us to the full meaning of compassion, which is doing something to relieve someone's pain. It is not enough to feel bad for those who are hurt. Compassion means getting involved, investing in others, and finding ways to bear someone's burden in order for healing to occur. Thank you.